Aloha. I'm Andy. In today's video, I will show how to fix the Compaq CQ58309SQ laptop for about $1. This is my friend's laptop, and he brought to me, because from a while it doesn't loads directly the operating system. He press the power button and instead of loading the operating system, appears a black screen with some messages. So let's diagnose and fix the problem. My phone camera didn't focus, so I made a photo. The message says, the CMOS checksum is invalid. The CMOS will be reset to the default configuration and will be rebooted. Please check your BIOS setup option to see if they change. CMOS reset, error code 502. Press enter to reboot the system. For more information, please visit www.hp.com/go/techcenter/startup. I tried the link, but it was a dead end. Usually if you get this error message, the BIOS battery is drained out or the BIOS is damaged. First I will disassemble the laptop and measure the BIOS battery. The difficulty level for the BIOS battery change for this laptop should be easy. It doesn't require high skill level. It can be done by anybody by following this step-by-step video. We need a Phillips screwdriver to remove the RAM and HDD cover door. To check the BIOS battery voltage we need a multimeter, and if the BIOS battery charging level is below 3 volts, then we need a good CR2032 battery. Step 1, I unplug the power cable and I remove the battery. Step 2, with a Phillips screwdriver I remove the RAM cover door holding screw and I remove the RAM cover door. Step 3, with a Phillips screwdriver I remove the HDD cover door holding screw and I remove the HDD cover door. There is the BIOS battery. I like it because it's the normal size CR2032 battery, it is easy to buy and cost about $1. Step 4, I remove the CR2032 BIOS battery. Step 5, with the multimeter I measure the voltage. A good BIOS battery charging level is above a little bit of 3 volts. If it's below then probably I find the problem, and the CR2032 BIOS battery charging level is about 0.066 volts. This is the new BIOS CR2032 battery. Step 6, I measure the replace battery voltage level, and it's about 3.038 volts, it should work with this. Step 7, I install the new BIOS CR2032 battery. Step 8, I mount back the HDD cover door and I screw in the holding screw. Step 8, I mount back the RAM cover door and I screw in the holding screw. Step 9, I put back the battery and I plug in the power cord. Step 10, I power on the laptop and I get the same error message because the BIOS battery was removed. I will let to load the Windows and then I will restart the laptop. Step 11, I'm turning off the laptop and I'm confident the error message will disappear. Step 12, I power on the laptop. And the error message doesn't show anymore, So I fixed the problem with a new CR2032 battery, that cost is about $1. In my next videos I will make a BIOS update and RAM upgrade for this laptop. If this video was useful to you and do you want to reward me with a cup of coffee, you can do it by clicking on the link in the description, select one cup and click on the support button. Thanks for watching, don't forget to share, comment, like, and subscribe. See you next time, goodbye.